invitation to address the Ardesh today on the topic of reconciliation and healing. I do appreciate your graciousness in inviting me to be here. I understand it's a stretch, and I appreciate that. And I've been asked, and I'm grateful to be here, to share a few brief thoughts on what might help authentic reconciliation and healing to be developed in our society. Remembering, of course, that reconciliation is not a project, but a process that, in fact, never ends. I'm very glad to do this and to share my few thoughts, but please note these are personal remarks. I don't speak with an official statement of the Methodist Church in Ireland or any other group, for that matter. The first thing that I want to say is that wouldn't reconciliation be very easy if we were all beginning with a blank sheet of paper? Wouldn't it be so much easier to be reconciled if we all didn't have a past? But of course, there is no blank sheet of paper. We all have a past, and we can't forget that. But the key issue for reconciliation is what we do with the memory now, and how do we unlock the future? And so in these few minutes, I want to just offer three challenges. The first one is a personal challenge to every single citizen, while the second two are more corporate challenges to Sinn Féin and indeed to all political parties in this land. But first, the personal challenge to every citizen. I would challenge every single person to make a point of going and looking for somebody that you know you will disagree with, and have a coffee with them, or tea if you prefer, or whatever else. In other words, take time to get to know them. The aim of the meeting isn't necessarily to come to agreement, but just to get to know the person who you disagree with. It's still all too easy in this land to spend our whole lives amongst people whom we agree with. And a segregated community where we only know people we agree with will never be reconciled. It's only as people from the other side become people that we know personally that the fear of difference can be removed. So that's the personal challenge I offer to every member of our society. Go and have a coffee with somebody you disagree with. And now on to two more corporate challenges. I've said already that, of course, we can't forget our past. But if healing and reconciliation are to come, then we need to find ways of remembering without celebrating, of commemorating without glorifying. People have many different ways of describing the Troubles, but one thing I think everybody can agree on is that there was no military victory for anybody. Clearly, many were killed and injured on every side, and clearly every side will want to commemorate and to remember. But when that is done in a glorifying, celebratory, victorious way, then it hinders reconciliation and increases pain instead of fostering healing. Furthermore, as we remember, we must also examine ourselves as to whether we need to apologize for wrong things we've done, even if we continue to believe they were done for the right reasons. And so if we regret any of the means we have used in the past, then we should express that regret. Because words of apology and regret can play an important part in opening the door to reconciliation and healing. And the other challenge that I would offer to Sinn Féin, and indeed to all the political parties in Northern Ireland, is this. During my year, which has just finished, as President of the Methodist Church in Ireland, I've had the opportunity to speak with political leaders of all persuasions. And you know what? I've heard them all say that they want the same thing. Namely, the betterment of life for all people in this society. Of course, they all have different understandings of how to achieve the betterment of life for all people in this society, but nevertheless, they're united in their desire for exactly that. So I would urge you and all the other parties to unite around on what you agree, which is that you want the best for all people. Get on with doing that. Start working together on issues that matter to people, and let the issues of sovereignty and so on, which divide us, follow in due course. I want to finish by referring to a conversation recorded in the Bible. You can't expect a Methodist minister to come here and not refer to the Bible. It's a conversation recorded in St. John's Gospel, chapter 4, between Jesus and a Samaritan woman whom he met at a well. And when they first met, they were separated by gender, by culture, by religion, by politics, and by history. Because he was a Jewish man and she was a Samaritan woman. And yet the encounter which they had at that well changed her life and in fact led to the transformation of the whole village and the surrounding area. But do you know how it began? It began when Jesus asked the woman to help him get a drink from the well. In other words, uniting around working for the essentials of life was the beginning of a process of healing and reconciliation. And so I pray that all the political parties here can unite around their common desire for the betterment of life for all people and start working together on these issues, even as disagreements on issues of sovereignty and history may persist. People reconcile as they work together. Garamila Mahalath.